One of the best things about Q-SYS is it's a, I'm getting a call. But wait, how do I know I'm getting a call? When your smartphone rings, a couple of things happen. First, a ring action occurs, which is usually an audible ringtone or a vibration, if you haven't silenced it, you monster. Simultaneously, a window appears on screen asking you if you want to accept or decline the call. This is the behavior we expect when someone's trying to call us on the phone. For instance, if your call is taking place on a video conferencing application, like Microsoft Teams or Zoom, you're used to getting that pop-up notification that someone is calling you on your monitor. But when you're using Q-SYS to manage the meeting room's microphones, loudspeakers, and cameras for the application via a Q-SYS AV bridging device, we also want to be able to control elements of the call itself using the Q-SYS touchscreen in the room. But how does your Q-SYS system know that you're getting a call? That's where the HID conferencing component comes into play. You'll find the HID conferencing component available on most core processors, as well as the NV32H and IO USB bridge. If you drag it into your schematic and open its control panel, you'll see it has exactly the controls you're looking for: a call accept, call decline, as well as a ring LED and others. Most modern video conferencing software these days are able to pass these kinds of information to Q-SYS. There are a few nuances to keep in mind. If you want to use it for Zoom, you'll need to enable the Zoom compatibility property over here in the right side pane. Also, if you're using it with Microsoft Teams, you might want to explore some of our other offerings to integrate Q-SYS into a Microsoft Teams room. Once your design is running, these controls automatically link to the active application running on the PC or compute device on the other end of the USB cable, the same USB cable that you're probably already using for your USB speakerphone. When your video conferencing application receives a call, it sends that info to Q-SYS and this ring LED engages. As for the touchscreen control, let's build a custom layer on your UCI to notify our room participants that a call is coming in. I'm going to create a new layer and name it something like Call Alert, and make sure it's the absolute highest layer on my UCI. Personally, I like to add a group box from the graphic tools that will obscure the majority of the page. I'll make mine quite dark, and I'll adjust its transparency so this blocks out most of the rest of the UCI, forcing the user to interact with this window. Let's drag the Call Accept and Call Decline buttons from the HID conferencing components onto this layer. I'll spend a little time to adjust their physical appearance to make this look good, and voila. Next, I'm gonna turn off the visibility of this layer because I want it to be invisible by default. I only want it to appear when the video conferencing application is ringing, which is exactly why we need this ring LED. Let's expose the LED ring control pin. And next, I'll go to my control components and grab a UCI layer controller, and then search for the visibility control pin for the layer in question. For me, I called it Call Alert. All we have to do is wire our ring LED to the Call Alert visibility, and we're done. When the conferencing application rings, it will turn on this layer, which overrides the rest of our screen. Once you press one of these buttons, it sends a signal to the video conference application on the connected PC or compute device to either accept or decline the call, exactly as if you would press those buttons on the application itself. And of course, once the ringing action is complete and the call is connected, the ring LED turns off, so your ringing layer will disappear again. By the way, you could build this same functionality if you're doing a voice call with a soft phone or a POTS controller as well. If you look at either the soft phone or POTS controller's control panels, you'll see they also have an LED called ringing. So you could use that to turn on your call alert layer, just like we showed for the HID conferencing component. For soft phone and POTS control panels, you can also select a ringtone from within their control panels, and you can even separate that ringtone to a separate audio channel if you engage their tone output pin if desired. So, that covers the ringtone and the control screen, but what if you want it to vibrate just like your smartphone? Well, you could use a GPIO to turn on a paint can shaker in your rack that's attached to your cord.
And that's why Nate doesn't work in tech support anymore. It was a bad day. Every day after was bad, too.
Beyond bringing up your call alert layer, you could do any number of other things within your design based on the call status information you get from the HID conferencing component. For example, if you want to mute the call, you should use this phone mute button rather than just muting the local microphones within Q-SYS, because this will also notify your conferencing app that you've chosen to go on audio mute, and the other participants will see that you're muted rather than just wonder if you're having mic issues. Or you might use the mute LED to activate a red light on your local microphones or on your UCI so that you'll know when you've been muted by the other party. This connected LED, that will be lit whenever it detects a connection to the USB connected PC. If this is off, you might want to use that to give yourself a warning that the PC isn't properly connected. You could also use the off-hook LED to launch confetti cannons to let you know that your conference call is off the hook! Okay, no. The off-hook LED just lets you know that you're in an active session. See, phones used to have a physical hook that was on a wall, and you, just saying this out loud makes me sound like a crazy person. But you could use this LED to transition your UCI to its conferencing screen, where your call volume and disconnect buttons undoubtedly live. This UCI is using layers to let the user navigate between multiple screens, which is being driven by the selection buttons of a selector component. This is an easy way to make sure that only one layer is visible at a time. I'll wire the off-hook LED to the conference selection button to make sure the UCI transitions to the applicable screen once the conference call is engaged. A user could still choose to navigate elsewhere on their own, of course, but this gives them the most likely controls they'll need right at their fingertips when the call begins. You could use this off-hook LED to do any number of other things too. Maybe you'll wire it to send signals to a third-party lighting system to make sure the lights are on in the room while the conference is active. Or you might wire it to a snapshot bank that raises the squelch priority of any PA announcements in your room so that your conference isn't interrupted just because Patrick's shortbread cupcakes are available by the water cooler.
The secret to good frosting is lard and love. And lard.
For more examples of all the different control components that we're using here and more, we'd strongly recommend that you check out the Control 101 training series. And for even more ideas, templates, to discuss other ideas, check out the QSC Communities page to connect with other QSYS developers. And lastly, while we're talking about this, you might notice there's also an HID media and HID keyboard component available. All these HID components, which stands for Human Interface Device, by the way, send commands to the USB connected PC in the same manner. The HID media block has some play, pause, transport, and volume controls that you could use to control a music application running on the PC, like Spotify or Pandora. And the HID keyboard provides a full keyboard, which would let you type on your PC from your Q-SYS touchscreen, just as if it were a connected USB keyboard. And that's it for HID devices and connecting your, oh, I'm getting a call, sorry. Yes, oh, Mr. Spielberg, yes, I am available if you can afford me. Sorry, I have to take this. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. No, I will not take second billing to DiCaprio.